everybody was.
All right, we're back.
With the Anthony Show.
Just once, I want to see that.
E-Rock just talked to the audience, Anthony, and are they asleep? The live studio audience? Nah, they're hanging. Friday's the day, by the way. If you're choosing a day to come check out the show, we could use the help on Friday. Because we are a little tired. We're getting ready for the weekend. We could use the energy of our listeners.
We're up playing poker. Not you. That's right. We were.
But we have an open door. You can come by any day. But if you decide Tuesday or Friday, you know, help us out and make Friday the day that we have a nice crowd.
I owe you guys an apology.
Oh, dude, what the fuck? I was just going to let it slide.
Because of the fucking...
We're doing this huge build-up.
Nobody told me. Nobody told me. I had no idea.
When I got the info, I'm like, he obviously didn't know.
Nobody told me. He would never do this stuff. Why the fuck would
Hold on, let me do that? Let me set it up. First of all, Patrice O'Neill's playing the Vegas show for us. We're talking about the ONA Traveling Virus Comedy Show. We kick it off April 14th in Vegas at the Hard Rock Hotel and Casino. The Joint. Tickets still available. Not many, by the way, through Ticketmaster.com. 8 or 9 comedians, blah, blah, blah. Go to the website for all the info. We haven't plugged this up. Then I get an email from Pete. Oh, that fucking loose again.
God damn, what happened?
Because we've been, like, you know, building up to the fact that we're going to do a press conference while we're out in Vegas and make a big deal. He's got some of the entertainment
channels. We're going to have a map with pins in it.
Dude, it's going to be great. Dude, yeah, map with pins.
Dude, the celebrities. Like all comics' heads on the map.
Oh, God. We got the interest of the entertainment channels, but not anymore, because now, like, oh, we got the info, so why should we send a crew to
God
Vegas?
God damn it.
happened was Louis, very excited. He's doing a few dates. We're going to do about 10 or so this summer. Mm-hmm. And Louis decided, you know, I got to start promoting these. I promote myself.
Well, here's from...
Like, we promote us ourselves. We understand that. So he adds his dates to his website. So our fans, that you know, they're always searching for some little tidbit of info that no one else has. Paul, by the way, being the dude that ends up getting Pete's number at his office, trying to confirm if what he's seeing on Louis's website is true. Fucking No Filter Paul. And then I think he leaked it to a newspaper because it hit the newspaper today. All because of Louis.
No, this is what happens
on his website. Because
I would have known when I'm in L.A. I have Sirius in my car, so I listen to you guys.
On Sirius?
Or whatever the fuck you're on.
XM.
Boy, you're... Oh, yeah, it's right on the mic. Yeah. On XM. I listen to XM. I'm in my car, and I listen to you guys, so I would have known. I would have heard, like, that there's a countdown or whatever the fuck was going on. But I'm in my apartment in my fucking underwear on my website, and I email my agent and said, just give me... I've got time. I never do this. I never do the promotion to set up my stuff, and I never... I'm a fucking lazy idiot. But I was sick, and I jerked off way too many times. Nothing left to do, so I wrote my agent and said, send me all my confirmed dates, everything I have that's confirmed. And there's a bunch of your dates in there.
I'm going to do some work today.
Yeah, so I sat there, and I posted them on my website, and I put them on my MySpace. And then I see on MySpace some guy writes, hey, thanks for the advance notice on those O&A dates. And I'm like, oh, okay.
Oh.
And then I get a Google news alert, you know, how Google will send you an email. Just like in 10 minutes, I get fucking, I'm in the fight. It says Times Herald leaked, Louis C.K. leaks O&A dates.
What
the fuck did I do?
Did you go like, I'm going to have a half?
Yeah, completely.
A slight panic, like, what
and
the
I get
fuck
a shitload of shit on my space of people saying, you let it out of there, going to be so mad at you. I'm like, what did I do?
Nah, we knew you didn't do it on purpose. But Pete was pissed like that.
If you told me not to say anything, I never would have said it.
That's what I think, because Pete called me last night, and he goes, you hear what happened with Louis? I'm like, Paul called me and told me what happened. I go, well, didn't somebody tell him?
Yeah,
like, when they gave him the dates, like, not to announce it, because anyone's going to want to promote it. And Pete said, he knew. And I'm like,
why would I know?
And I'm like, well, why would he?
No, I called my agent right away.
I post him if he knew not to.
I called my manager, my agent, and I said, one of you guys tell me not to say something and I forgot? And they're like, no, we don't know what the hell you're talking about.
I told Pete.
We don't know what you're talking about.
Yeah. Don't worry about it. We should get Pete on the phone. It could be funny.
Yeah.
Hey, we got Finger 11 out there. They're big rock stars. They've been just hanging out. We can't even see them. Can you hear us?
Yeah, they're kind of over there where we don't have a window. They're in between the door and the window. There we go. Hey, how you doing?
We got Scott Anderson, the vocalist for Finger 11, and James Black, the guitarist. What's up, guys?
There's one mic.
Not very much.
Yeah.
Well, security.
There it is.
Is the mic on?
Yes.
Yeah, the mic's on.
And they're testing.
There they are.
Am I on?
Yeah.
I'm sorry, you guys. You caught me warming up, trying to be professional.
Were you?
Well, that lasted about 3 minutes.
Well, you picked the wrong place to try to be a professional. Yeah. Didn't you take a look around this joint? You're like, they're set up in a cubicle somewhere. We can't see them.
I can sort of see you guys.
Our audience is scaring them.
Well, that can't be helped. Yeah, you guys are playing like in a cubicle. That's weird. They're kind of stuck in there.
Yeah, none of this makes sense.
Doesn't that go against being a rock star?
Yeah.
When you have to start performing inside a cubicle.
And memos during their set.
You know what doesn't make sense? We got here before anyone. We were like the most punctual dudes here. We were like 7:30.
Wow.
Yeah.
Holy shit, we're not done with the other show until 9.
It makes no fucking sense. Because, I mean, what are you going to do? Musicians aren't supposed to be here till like, you know, noon.
That's kind of good, though, because that gives you some talking time, so you're not waking up and singing.
Yeah, exactly.
That's kind of...
Yeah, I think that was the point, but that's not really funny, is it?
No, it's just very informative.
Hey, you...
What the fuck do I know?
Hey, I was reading up on you guys, and something that struck me as interesting. You guys used to be known as Rainbow Butt Monkey.
How did I know you were going to find that fact?
Well, come on. That's
especially today, with all the animal love going on.
Well, yeah. Did that... did you feel like you were in the right place when you heard us talking about the sex with animals?
Kinda, you know what? Kind of, sort of. I was like, okay, how are we going to explain them our high school band name? But it'll be thematic. That'll be cool. I mean, that's what it was. We were just, that was our high school band name. We thought it was awesome.
Just throw some words together and...
Yeah, that's all you need.
Butt monkey.
You want to be in a band? Just
how high were you guys when you came up with Rainbow Butt Monkeys?
I don't think we were smoking weed at that point.
No, we were still too young.
It's a different story now, but...
Never too young, sir.
Yeah, we just...
Hey, wait a minute. You guys are going to admit that you smoke weed?
Well, why not?
No, that's cool. I mean, most of the bands these days...
Smoking weed's cool, kids.
I'll tell you something.
No, it is cool. Especially in rock music, it's cool. Like, lately, you talk to these bands like, ah, man, I'm straight edge. I'm vegetarian all the way.
Oh, yeah,
no drugs. No,
it's a good marketing angle.
My body's a temple. Bullshit.
Well, you know what the problem is? I can't smoke weed on the road because of my voice. It screws things up too much, right?
Yeah.
But everybody else is like, it's a constant party.
Somewhere, I'm trying to remember the year, because Ann and I have been going backstage forever.
I can't remember the year either.
No, but I'm serious. Like, there was a turn. It was in around 2000 or something. We're backstage, and all these guys that are like all tatted up and pierced and everything going on with their bodies, you see them like getting a vegetarian meal and drinking like bottled water, and there was no sign of debauchery whatsoever. And then they go on stage and act like animals.
Yeah,
and like, what happened to our rock stars where what you saw on stage was happening behind the scenes?
They're dead from drinking too much and smoking and doing drugs.
Yeah, but there's something to be said about
motherfuckers.
That.
They didn't make it.
Exactly. I remember that era you're talking about, though, and I think it's sort of gone. I'm not really sure. I think it was more of an angle or something.
Well,
you know?
Patrice Francine's here.
Yeah.
We saw her walk by.
Yeah, we're going to have Patrice Francine do the news a little later. But it's good to know you guys are doing the weed. So you guys are from Canada, right?
Yes.
Sorry.
Not much competition as far as bands go in Canada.
Well, that's kind of good.
Isn't it like a law that like all the radio stations have to play every Canadian band like every 10 minutes?
There's a little bit of that for sure.
Yeah.
You know?
Yeah. It's probably easier for a band to get airplay up there.
It should be. It never worked for us until recently. But
When I worked in Buffalo Radio, close enough to Canada, so some of these stations came in and they had this rule. It's got to be like 30% or 40%. Canadian bands. Yeah. So you heard so much fucking Neil Young, so much Rush, and I can't even name a third. Bryan Adams, maybe.
Yeah,
Bryan Adams.
It's worse in Montreal and Quebec, right? Because there's not only the percentage of Canadian content, it has to be French Canadian content.
And that
so that's like
hot.
Some pretty alienating
that shit
stuff
is really
there.
Good.
Mm-hmm.
Some of my favorite music is Quebec French music.
Awesome. Not even just French, but Quebec French.
Oh yeah. I don't have enough room on my iPod for all of
I had to get an 80 gig to put all my
great stuff.
Favorite Quebec.
Well, it's Finger 11. They're promoting Them Versus You Versus Me, right?
Brand new record came out a couple weeks ago, yeah.
And the single is Paralyzer.
Yep.
And you guys want to play something for us today?
Well, yeah, we do. Are we going to go for it now?
Yeah, whatever, dude. Whatever you're feeling, man.
Okay, well, then we'll... Yeah, all right,
live
we'll
audience
just,
there for you.
All right, let's see how this goes. This is a song off the... somebody's cell phone. All right.
I heard so this. Board gossip theme, I think.
This is
stupid listeners. Turn off your fucking phone.
I gotta make sure that's not mine. All right, so this is from the new record. This is called Talking to the Walls.
Mm-hmm.
hostage has been held like I've been holding mine, but I'm just fine since I've been without you. No prisoner could climb the walls that I built up in my mind since I've been without you. But I'm holding down and out. I'm desperate without you. Look at the shape I'm in. Talking to the walls again. Look at the state I'm in. Bent and broken is all I've been. No other universe but mine could ever feel as unaligned since I've been without you. No instances from time to time that feel like things will turn out right since I've been without you. But I'm holding down and out. I'm desperate without you. Look at the shape I'm in. Talking to the walls again. Look at the state I'm in. Bent and broken is all I've been. Look at the shape I'm in. I'm talking to the walls again. Look at the state I'm in. I'm bent and broken is all I've been. Look at the shape I'm in. Talking to the walls again. Look at the state I'm in. Bent and broken is all I've been. No universal truth this time.
All right, they liked them.
There you go.
Finger 11. Hey, that was awesome. The voice sounds great this early in the morning. Very good.
Thanks.
No, I'm not kidding. That was really, really good.
Thanks a lot. That's
very
cool.
Very, very nice.
I'm getting good reviews over here.
You're getting great reviews on Pal Talk and on the instant feedback. Finger 11. The album cool. Them versus You versus Me. And Scott, you're into the World of Warcraft.
Yeah, that's true. Okay, who's coming up with this? This is not on the bio, sir.
Hey, man, we dig deep.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. Me and Rick play a lot.
And that was you were in Taiwan for a while.
No, or? I'm an EverQuest EQ2 guy.
Wow, that's pretty cool.
I went old school.
That's really old school.
I have a character from like the year the fucking game started, so you know, I couldn't really. And everyone's like, dude, you gotta try WoW, dude, you gotta try WoW, and I tried it. Couldn't get into it as much as stupid EverQuest.
Well, do you find it's kind of a hard sell when you talk about this kind of shit, like where it's like, if nobody plays games, it's like, what the hell are you doing?
You're speaking faggot.
You gotta be really careful.
If somebody knows what you're talking about, you can talk for hours about the games that you play.
Yeah.
If someone doesn't know, they're just like, dude, what, you're like, you're spending 16 hours trying to get a robe? What the fuck are you talking about?
There's no context for anybody.
You just don't understand, man.
Wait, you were on a raid that took like 8 hours to get together, and it ended in a minute? What the fuck? What are you talking about?
Yeah. Well, you ever think that, I hate to sound like a faggot.
Don't worry.
But that the rest of your life is the same thing? Like, all the time you spend obsessing on whatever it is, your career and your finances, it's the same just bullshit. When you walk away from your role-play game, it all vanishes into nothing. It's fucking useless.
Yeah, it's just it's nothingness.
But
that's life, too, though.
Yeah, but you sort of walk around like you kind of feel like you have the chest of the character you created for a minute.
Yeah, like
you've got the weapons on your belt.
As you're playing, you're kicking ass.
Yeah, you feel it. You really feel it. You feel that power. Well, isn't the rest of your life the same thing?
Like, yeah.
Isn't it just, it's just horse shit?
It's bullshit.
Fucking virtual thing you made up.
Yeah, pretty much.
But it's more.
You get your moments of glory, and then most of the time, though, you're just running around looking for something to do.
Yeah, exactly.
Here's a question I got for Scott and Anthony. What's your character doing right now?
Virtually sitting.
Just waiting for you to pick up the
waiting
game again?
Waiting for you.
Is he in a forest?
Fucking a dog.
Is he in a dark forest? Where is he?
Yeah.
He's just sitting in the virtual world waiting for you to pick up the old game again?
Because at this point, there's no more grinding left. You've got to hit all these levels, right? And then when you hit the highest level, it is about sitting around waiting 8 hours for raids and stuff. So
I feel about my career sometimes. Like, I'm this guy, this comedian, who's just sitting, occasionally just sitting in a chair, not doing nothing. I'm like, I gotta work that fucking guy again.
Yeah,
make some fucking phone calls, book some shit for that asshole comedian that I,
you're right.
I created.
How often, in like any given day, are you actually spending time working?
Are you actually working your thing?
Something. You're working your thing.
No.
And how much time are you sitting around wasting time?
Yeah, wasting
doing
huge
nothing.
Huge amount.
Like that was epiphany. Like,
I need someone to power level my life. That's what people need. Shirt. Someone to help you power level your own life.
Exactly.
I feel that way with some of the TV characters. You watch some of these shows you're into, and you're like, God, they're just living this character all the time. And you get to meet them, like, dude, I fucking filmed that 8 months ago. I've been just hanging out in a Starbucks every day waiting for my next gig.
Yeah, exactly. Like, I used to watch that show Oz, and some of the characters lived in my neighborhood, and I hated seeing them. Like that Beecher guy. Like, you just shit in that guy's mouth yesterday. And now you're wearing a sweater having brick oven pizza at fucking Picasso Cafe. Like, it doesn't make sense.
It's so out of context.
Hey, Finger 11.
Hey.
MySpace.com/Finger11. Are you guys promoting anything else?
That's pretty much it. We're just going to be on tour forever.
Are you guys doing anything in New York?
No.
Really?
Then why the fuck?
We're doing this and then we're like
sitting around
shipping off
nothing.
Again. We're I don't know where we are. I think we're going to we're blowing going off New York and going to Detroit.
Why would you go to Detroit?
As so many do.
Why would you go to Detroit?
I think there's a gig, you know?
Yeah, we don't know much about Detroit.
Can you what's the style that particular style, all the songs, that type of acoustic?
No, it's a little bit all over the map.
All right, because I was wondering how the name Paralyzer would come from that style. Like, what song you could do.
There you go. It doesn't translate from song to
acoustically
song.
At all, so we don't even bother trying.
Yeah, it's you know, they're not acoustic.
Yeah, they're much better when they plug in. I mean, not much better, much different.
Nah, these guys famous. I'm not even trying to be funny. Are you guys famous?
No. Finger 11. That was. I swear to God, you sound great. I meant to say much different when they plug in. I said much better, which was.
Are these now? You need to just school me on White World. How? In terms of, like, say, LL Cool J famous, are you LL Cool J famous? Are you Little Kim famous?
Travis!
In terms of white people.
Bring in Travis. Oh,
Travis is the resident expert.
Travis, how huge is Finger 11 compared to maybe the rap community? This could go very good for you guys, very well for you guys, or very bad. Go ahead, Travis.
A little
Travis.
In comparison to...
Explain Finger 11 to, obviously, Patrice, who's never heard of him.
In black artist terms.
Oh. For the four people that are black that are listening.
Are they Denzel Washington, or are they Gabrielle Union?
Jimmy J.J. Walker.
Exactly. Walker, or...
Jimmy,
Billy D. Williams famous.
Nipsey Russell, maybe?
Huh?
Denzel and Gabrielle.
Denzel is Denzel, and then Gabrielle Union is like, white people go, who? Gabrielle? Who the fuck is that? But black people know him, but it's like, who the fuck is that? Everybody knows Denzel. So I'm saying, in terms of how would I understand how big they are?
I'd say closer to Gabrielle than Denzel.
Yeah, but pick somebody. Pick a black artist of anything that you could then say, all right.
Rapper, Nelly or Mobb Deep, you know, somebody
Mobb
that's...
Mobb Deep.
So,
they are getting a lot of airplay.
They're known to the white people who know the music that...
Oh, yeah,
that's listen. Okay,
yeah.
All right.
Patrice,
so.
We're downplaying this because we're just dopes, but these guys are pretty big.
They're Mobb Deep big. I know how big they fucking are. Right, explain yeah. it.
Don't get defensive now.
They're pretty
you
big.
You spent 8 minutes explaining it to you. Don't act like you've always
I'm
known
saying,
it.
No,
I know how big they are. You no, think man, I'm no, stupid? No.
You just found out in front of us.
Thank you. No, thank you. Not that I'm saying. No,
this guy gets away with murder around here.
I'm saying that Travis, he explained how big they are.
It's like teaching my wife how to drive.
It's very respectful.
Oh, shit.
It's like teaching my wife how to drive. She doesn't know anything. I'm like, okay, put it in drive. I know how to put... Well, I fucking told you how to put it in drive. So don't act like I'm talking like you're stupid.
Fuck you!
Fuck you!
You Monte Cole!
Monte Cole.
What do you people say?
Monte Cole.
Yeah, thank you. Thank you very much.
Hey, don't point that finger
at me. No, when you said... thank you, Travis.
Louis was onto something there.
I know how
take
big...
Take your beating.
...they was.
Just take your beating.
Once he said Mobb Deep, I
once
knew how big
they right, okay. You know how big Mobb Deep is.
Yes, thank you very much.
Hey, can we get another one out of you guys?
Yeah.
I mean, you're set up and all.
All right, so this is the thing. This you might recognize this. Speaking of, I mean, this song is kind of bigger than the band, I would say. I don't know.
Can you do Acoustic Paralyzer?
It's like our hit. No, you know what? It just sucked too much. We
yeah,
tried
said
it
already.
We're like, nah, it's not cool.
Yeah, do your hit.
So here it is. Yeah, ready? Here goes.
Here's the hit.
Restless tonight, 'cause I wasted the line. Between both these times, I drew a really thin line. It's nothing I planned, and it's not that I can. But you should be mine, across that line. If I traded it all, if I gave it all for one thing, and just for one thing. If I sorted it out, if I knew all about this one thing, wouldn't that be something? I promise I might not walk on by. Maybe next time, but not this time. 'Cause even though I know, I don't wanna know. Yeah, I guess I know, I just hate how it sounds. If I traded it all, if I gave it all away for one thing, just for one thing. If I sorted it out, if I knew all about this one thing, wouldn't that be something? 'Cause even though I know, I don't wanna know. Yeah, I guess I know, I just hate how it sounds. Even though I know, I don't wanna know. Yeah, I guess I know, I just hate how it sounds. If I traded it all, if I gave it all away for one thing, just for one thing. If I sorted it out, if I knew all I something. And if I traded it all, if I gave it all away for one thing, just for one thing. And if I sorted it out, if I knew all about this one thing, wouldn't that be something?
Finger 11. It's one thing. Very good, guys. Bravo. By the way, people are trying to explain to Patrice how big Finger 11 is. They were on Leno.
Mm-hmm.
Gives a shit.
That's a true story. We got on Leno a couple times.
So. Well, that's what I was going to say. That's no big deal because even Ant and I were on Leno once. So.
It wasn't our first rodeo.
It's not even engage anymore. It's just put it this way. Do your fans hate you now?
Oh, no, you mean, you have to ask them.
So your core fans still love you?
I think a good portion of them may hate us, a good portion of them.
You know what,
yeah, if your core fans still love you, then you're not big yet. As soon as they turn on you, then
they almost hate us.
See, we keep doing records that don't really sound alike. We kind of keep doing our own thing, and I think it's a little, it's confusing. You know, it's not sort of a homogenous deal, so it's kind of hard to kind of keep on the same wavelength is like, you know, your favorite band. It's like, you know, it's like anything. It's like sometimes you want that AC/DC record that's like pure consistency, and then sometimes, I don't know, you want to hear your favorite band dick around.
I like these guys. You're grounded.
Yeah.
You don't have that dumb attitude we're sick of.
You still get groupie pussy? Like, is that still a part of the lifestyle?
Who's married?
Well, there's a lot of guys that are married.
Yeah.
Fuck that. How about you, lead singer? How about you with the soul, baby? Are you getting some ass or what?
I'm not married.
What's the question is, Canadian, are you getting...
Canadian.
Which is sneaky. Don't dodge around it. Are you getting some side pussy, man? You getting some good pussy on the road.
Go ahead.
I've got a steady girl, so it's not like it used to be, you know? So it's like you got to sort of be a good kid on the road. Or, you know, this day and age, you're pretty much...
Bullshit. Yeah, you said it all.
Are you kidding me? It's not even worth it, dude. There's too many internet.
He puts the song out like one thing, so the chick at home's like, all right, see, I know where his head's at. But on the road, it's 25 things.
Was you fucking raw like in the Yucatan? You can fuck raw in the Yucatan, right? AIDS didn't get to the Yucatan yet.
You get to go places where AIDS hasn't made its appearance yet.
Shit, Vancouver. Ain't no AIDS in Vancouver, nigga.
Fucking Yucatan. You're thinking of the Yukon, you fucking idiot.
The Yucatan Peninsula is
like
south
Yucatan.
Of Mexico.
That's like, wait a minute.
Yucatan.
It took y'all a second to know I didn't know what the fuck I was talking about. Yukon's in there.
You know, I was trying to think of like, Yucatan. I'd say there's probably AIDS there.
I think that's where it started.
I didn't care. It came from the fucking
I didn't care of the Acapulco.
Accuracy.
I was with you, Patrice. I just enjoyed the joke.
No, that's true. It works without the geography.
And also, we were talking about video games. Some dude from Elmira, while you guys were learning how to level up your blood elf, mage, image, help me out here.
Mage?
I don't know. Mage?
Yeah, mage.
I was learning how to unfasten a bra with one hand. Great time.
Oh, yeah, Mr.
Yeah, right.
Fucking ladies, man.
Shut
you mean with your
fuck
up. Your mother's bra around your fucking bed. Something.
I can't just read it.
If he knows about blood elves, what the fuck is he
yeah,
talking
exactly.
about?
Oh, he knows a little too much.
Yeah. He has time to send in a message, too.
Knows a little too much.
All right, we got to take a break.
What, is he virtually married?
Hey, douchebag. Finger 11.
Can I ask a quick question? What's the benefit now to being a rock star now that everything is not... You know, you can't go out and do all that rock star shit. Like, what is, other than artistic expression, what is the benefit now? What do you wish to...
I like that question.
Well, yeah. There's that dorky love of music and doing something with your friends. You know,
other than that, the artistic, like, the thing where y'all get to bring, you know, just say it and shit. I'm talking about the extracurricular thing, like being better than the average citizen.
All right. Well,
fame
I mean,
and fortune, probably.
You get paid to run around the planet and drink and hang out with your friends.
Yeah.
That's See? Pretty odd. It's a good gig, you know?
Sure enough.
It's a comic. Nah, you know, it's not enough anger.
There's nothing artistic
not
about
anger.
That.
Not no. enough anger.
Why are you mulling it over?
Yeah, I'm just
like
saying,
that?
Where's the anger in the world now, man? God damn it.
Oh, we made a bunch of angry records,
tattoos?
Man.
Tattoos? You motherfuckers probably ain't got no tattoos or nothing.
There's a bunch. I don't have any, but there's a bunch of
them.
Go
look at them, Patrice. Jeez.
And this guy designed them and stuff, so that's all right.
All right. Hey, I like them. I just want somebody to die of a heroin overdose. Then I'll really love these
then motherfuckers. Then you'll start picking up the records. That's phase two.
Hey, guys, it's up to you. You could play us out around 11 in about a half hour, or we could say goodbye now.
You know what? Let's say goodbye. I'm annoyed at my voice. It sucks.
What?
You know what? I've been dealing with like this cough, and I'm on antibiotics.
I thought
AIDS. Fuck.
Sorry.
It's just you, bro. Everyone AIDS voice.
No, Yucatan. Raw the Yucatan.
Yeah, we just got back from the Yucatan, so I got to deal with this.
It's just you. The feedback's been great on you guys. So.
Oh, that's awesome.
It's Finger 11. They're promoting.
Oh, not the people talking. You've been feeding back.
Oh, it sounds good. Like a Hendrix concert.
The album's Them Versus You Versus Me, which is a lot different than what you guys heard today, which was also very good, the acoustic stuff. So, all right. Anything else you want to get off your chest there?
No, just thanks for having us. That's cool.
Scott Anderson, the vocalist, and James Black, the guitarist. Thank you so much.
Thanks, thank guys.
All right, we're going to take a break. We got Louis C.K. We just asked him. He said yes. He's going to do from 11 to 12 today live for everybody.
We have
Francine here who's going to do the news. Yeah, Louis doesn't know what he's going to do.
I don't know what he's going to do.
He's just going to turn on the mic on and see where it goes,
just
which I think
could yap, plunk some funk down,
cool.
You'll be fine.
Okay.
And we got Francine with the news we could do next for Patrice.
I love Francine.
And we could also get to know the audience because there's some doozies out there, man. There's a guy that does gangbang parties. There's a guy that was attacked by a dog as a kid. Dog ripped his face off.
Jesus Christ. It looks all right.
You?
You can't say a dog ripped his face off and then stand there with a face.
No, it's sad. Half the crowd.
Standing there with your face.
With your fucking face.
No, it's sad, though, Louis. Half the crowd pointed at the one dude, and it's not him. That's
it must have been him.
That's not good. But
oh, no.
And remember, then we have a...
And Willie Nelson's here.
Yeah, Willie Nelson's here. Yes, a younger version of Willie Nelson. Also a guy that saw a retarded Asian midget in Target. And remember Time of Our Life, one of our favorite bits of all time?
Yep.
The guy, Dan, is here, who gave us that song back in the day.
Wow.
And he's got a band, and he would like us to play one of his tracks, so maybe we'll do that as well.
Does it have the same lead singer as Time of My Life? Because that guy could sing.
It's too long to play now, isn't it?
Yeah.
All right, we'll just break and we'll continue.